Anglian Water is a regional water company, so we cover from the Humber Bank all the way down to South Essex. So we have around 7 million customers across our whole region. So within the company there's about 6,000 employees, and with all our partners as well it gets up to around 10,000. So it's a pretty big part of the east of England in terms of our employee numbers. We were the first company, our first water company, to put purpose at the heart of the organisation, so in the Articles of Association. So we're here for our customers and for the environment. And you genuinely feel it through the organisation. People care about the stuff that we do. So kind of all the standards that we adopt and the ways of working, they are genuinely for our employees. Like, people feel like it's like a family organisation to work here, and most people who work in the region live in the region. So they're putting something back around the environment where they've got, and we get a really, really kind of good relationship between the company and the employees that work for us.
I've been at Anglian Water for nearly 2 years now. When I applied to Anglian Water, actually the first thing that I noticed was the purpose. I always remember my first impressions when I was going through the recruitment process. And it was all about, Gemma, just be yourself. When you can 100% just be yourself, you just are a better person, you just show up better, you're just more your natural self, you're not having to try. And I think naturally, as a company, you get the most out of someone when they are just doing things effortlessly.
So we have 10 standards with BSI, with some of our more recent additions being the Inclusive Customer Service Kite Mark and the Wellbeing Standard. So one of the many reasons that we have standards at Anglian Water is to provide third-party assurance to all of our stakeholders and also to continuously improve our systems and the ways that we operate. So at Anglian Water, we're long-standing holders of the 45001 management system for health and safety. So when we saw the ISO 45003 standard, we thought that would be a great natural evolution to our existing management system for health and safety. As a company, we hold wellbeing in the same regard as we do health and safety, so it just felt like a really natural expansion.
Having the standard has really impacted our employees positively through building trust, confidence, and also engagement as well. Through achieving the standard, we've been able to look at some of our root causes of poor mental health and ensure we've got the right support there as well from a primary control measure. So that's all about having the right guidance and policies in place. A secondary control measure, looking at what we do to promote good mental health through a whole wellbeing strategy, and tertiary measures as well, as far as having the right support in place, such as private healthcare and virtual GP. Nothing's more important than our people in our business. And it has some really sort of tangible results as well, as far as reducing sickness absence and improving retention as well. It helps us fulfil our corporate social responsibilities and become an employer of choice, but ultimately it aligns with one of our values, which is doing the right thing.
Anglian Water have been really, really encouraging about me and others sharing their own personal stories. Last year I shared my personal story around breast cancer, which I was diagnosed with 7 years ago to the week, and being able to feel that it's okay to be vulnerable and to share that has allowed me to raise a lot of awareness in terms of getting other people to start checking themselves, or even encouraging their partners, sisters, mums to do the same. More recently, I was suffering from a mini burnout, and again, I shared my story to over 100 people on what it was like, how I'd noticed the triggers, how I was dealing with it, and how I was getting out the other side. You know, it's about normalising talking. We don't need our armour on, and that it's okay not to be okay. So my message to other organisations would be to put your humans first. We're human. Sometimes we have good days, sometimes we have bad days, but just to always be there for the human.